Southwest, the heart of the fan.
To the afternoon edition of Stars Live, a Saturday matinee at American Airlines Center as the Dallas Stars host the Pittsburgh Penguins. The Stars are coming off of an exciting shootout win Thursday night to restart the season. The AAC has been rocking as of late, and the fans are rolling in to watch some midday hockey in the Big D. Welcome into American Airlines Center. I'm Lauren Callender alongside Brian Ray and Brent Severin. And guys, we've got two matinee games back to back. Pittsburgh today before the team heads to St. Louis, but Thursday night, what a way to restart this season. This building was the place to be in Dallas Thursday night.
It's not a coincidence that this team is doing well on home ice, especially with the atmosphere after the restart, Sevy, but a lot of streaks this season have ended inside American Airlines Center. We'll see if the Stars can do that to Pittsburgh's 10-game heater.
Yeah, Pittsburgh comes in one of the best teams on the road in the National Hockey League. The Stars, 12-3-1 record here at home, and you know what they can do here. They've been strong. We've got a little jump in the building today. A lot of Pittsburgh fans, but the Stars fans will be full bore, and we're definitely in one today, aren't we?
we are on one today, Sevy. Well, the Stars have found a way to get it done in their last three. Scoring has not been an issue, and they've done so in a variety of ways, breaking down scoring in the last three. 10 even strength goals, 5 on the man advantage, even a shorty in there, and of course Thursday night's shootout. It's encouraging to see the Stars take advantage of any situation they may find themselves in, Brian.
Well, Laura, they say variety is the spice of life, and that is what is going on with the Dallas Stars offense right now. They're averaging 2.88 goals a game this season, which is up by a decent margin over the last few years. Roope Hintz, Jason Robertson, they certainly add to that, Sevy, but the thing that amazes me is they've been doing this without that significant push from their blue line. We're used to this team being up there in defensive scoring. There is still another layer that could come for this offense, it feels like.
Yeah, that's the good news. There's no question about that. But when you look at the offense, I look at the even strength goals. That is the bread and butter of every single team that is successful in the National Hockey League. Yeah, you got to contribute on the power play. Yeah, it's nice to get a shorty. And, of course, Stars have been excellent in the overtime frame. But those even strength goals, I believe, are the balance for any team.
Well, a big component of the Stars scoring in the last few games has come from the Sagan Ben Gurionov line. This line has accounted for 11 points in the last two games. Sagan and Ben, each with a pair of goals in the last game. Gurionov with a goal and 4 helpers in that span. This line has been great in the last two showings, but the focus has really been centered around Dennis Gurionov.
Yeah, it has to be. He's the guy, I believe, with the highest ceiling. The young player can be just dynamite in this league, and obviously we've talked about it a lot, Brian, the consistency. He's a big body. You know, he's 6'2". He's getting close to 220 pounds up there, and he's got some speed and talent. We need more of this. This hard hustle, hard work to the net. Once he gets it, we know he can do this kind of damage. That trio is vital to this team.
Roope Hintz uses his speed to be disruptive on the puck, forechecking and backchecking. Dennis Gurionov, you saw that goal when he forced the turnover on the goaltender and even forcing things at the blue line right there. It's the same thing with his speed. Be disruptive with the puck. When you disrupt things, even at neutral ice, it's going to spring opportunities for you, and more consistency in doing that is going to be big for him.
Well, coming off of Thursday's win, head coach Rick Bowness met with his team in preparation of Pittsburgh's visit to Dallas to talk about the team game and what needs to be done in this contest. Here's what Bones had to say.
As loose as we were in the first period last night, we can't afford to do that tomorrow because we will be behind the eight ball and we're not going to let that happen. So we met with the players this morning, and we just some visual reminders of our structure and some visual reminders of competing and the visual reminders of trusting each other out there. Three things that kind of got away from us at times last night, but as the game wore on, we built those three things back into our team game.
Talk about those things, structure, compete, and trust. What stands out to you as the biggest component that this team needs to focus on?
Yeah, the trust is the last thing that you have to trust your teammates within that structure, because the structure is what makes this difference than the minor leagues or any other leagues in the world. It happens quickly, but you have to have structure to get the puck out. If you have that, you're okay. The biggest thing also is compete. You got to be able to compete against the opponent, and without that, you're going to see a huge difference in team. And the trust is at the very end, because everything happens so fast. If I'm a defenseman and I'm asked to be along the boards, I have to trust that my winger is back to help me out. If not, structure, compete doesn't work.
And for a team like Dallas that really is not going to blow the doors off offensively, I know they scored 6 goals against Florida. It was great, but this is normally a 3-2 team. You know, those little details are what separates them in games to pick up wins.
Well, tonight, for me, compete is what stands out against this team. The Penguins are red hot right now, riding a 10-game win streak, outscoring opponents 45-20 in that time. Special teams obviously are performing well in that span, but looking at these numbers, the Penguins have only allowed 20 goals throughout this streak, and when this team's offense has typically been at the forefront of their success, that goals against number really stands out, Brian.
Yeah, you think of names like Crosby and Malkin and back when they were winning cups and there was a lot of offensive firepower, but this team allows the fourth fewest shots in the NHL. They are the best penalty-killing team in the National Hockey League. They have a goaltender that is top 3 in goals against average and save percentage. Sevy, this 10-game heater they're on, it starts in net and it's moved forward defensively for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, when you're outscoring teams 45 to 20, yeah, you got something going on in both ends of the rink. But also when you look at it, it's how they start games over the 10-game heater, as you call it. 17-1, they're outscoring opponents in that initial frame. So hard to come back in the National Hockey League. So obviously, to start this one, the Stars got to be ready to go.
Well, the Stars took the meeting between the two last time back in October. But if you remember, this Pens team was without Sidney Crosby in that matchup. And he's been pretty successful against the Stars throughout his career, Brian.
Well, he's had 2 points in his first 7 games this season because he was coming back from that injury. You see what he's done in his career against the Stars. He loves playing Dallas, but 22 points in his last 14 games. It took him a while to get going, Sevy. He's clearly on all cylinders now, and the offense runs through him. No player on Pittsburgh averages more time in the offensive zone possessing the puck than number 87, which you would think, given his pedigree.
Well, yeah, you want to talk about a guy who's got skill and compete level. We just talked about Gurianov to elevate his compete level every single shift. Well, there's no question you're going to see that from Crosby. And if you look at Crosby, he's got a 5-game heater, again, as you say, against the Stars. When he's in the lineup, they're beating the Dallas Stars. Obviously, the Stars beat them last time they were in, but Sidney Crosby was not in the lineup.
Sidney Crosby anchors a line that has played really well in the Pens' last 3 games alongside Jake Guentzel and Brian Rust. They've accounted for 23 Pens points. Rust with 7 goals in the last 3 games. But news heading into today's game, guys, Brian Rust will not be playing as he and Brock McGinn have been added to the COVID-19 protocol list. However, these guys will still be something to watch today.
The loss of Rust is a big hit to them, Sevy. In all 3 of them, they really have not played a lot of time together because of injuries and health. Once they finally got together over these last 3-4 games, they started clicking immediately and making up for lost time. We'll see what the offense looks like without Rust, but still, with Guentzel and Crosby, you have to be aware of what is a dangerous offensive hockey team at times.
Yeah, and the biggest thing they do is keep that puck underneath the circles, and they give me a headache to watch offensively, watching them score goals, the 3 of them together. And like you mentioned, one of them is not going to be in the lineup tonight. But yeah, once they cycle the puck low, they get the puck on their stick, they make opponents pay. So the Stars are going to have to be, of course, keying on those 2 guys.
All right, guys, well, we're going to head to break, but when Stars Live returns, Razor joins us to talk about the Dallas Stars' success right here at home. That and more coming up next. The Dallas Stars hosting the Pittsburgh Penguins today. Another big test for this Dallas Stars team at home, but American Airlines Center seems to be the place where the Stars can make it happen. When you look at teams around the league who have played well at home, Dallas right up there alongside Carolina, Colorado, and Florida when it comes to home points percentage. Thursday night, this place was rocking. And with more on the Stars' home success, we welcome Razor into the show. Razor, the American Airlines Center has been such a fun place to watch this team this season. How do you explain their success at home, and what makes the AAC so difficult for opponents to play in?
Yeah, it's like the nets are bigger here or something. The offense flows at American Airlines Center. We've seen that. Certainly in the last 11 games or so, they've only been beaten once. They're averaging about 4 goals a game, and a lot more than that the last 3. There's a confidence that comes with the group. You can see it in them now. You know, that you start stacking up victories in your home building, and you come to the rink with the expectation, not the hope, but the expectation that you're going to win the hockey game. So They could be a little stingier defensively than what we've seen the last few games, but they're outscoring their issues in that department. And I know it's cliche, but finding a way to win is a reality for this team on home ice right now. Because of their confidence, whether they're down or ahead by a goal, they feel like they're going to win the game in the end. Nice place to be for them.
Well, Rays, the latest challenge for the Dallas Stars is the Pittsburgh Penguins. 10 straight wins for this Pens team. What kind of animal is Dallas dealing with today to try and continue this home success?
Well, the impressive thing with the Penguins is it hasn't really mattered where they've played, whether it's been on the road or at home. They just win consistently here lately. And what they do, I think, better than any team in the league is come out of the gates early and outplay their opponent in the opening period, and then that sets up their very rich, hardworking, fast checking game. They don't give up much. You're not going to score against their penalty killing very often. You're not going to score against them, period, very often. So it's in the Stars' best interest, I think, to play with a lead here tonight, not chase them a little bit, or today, and not chase them a little bit. They're going to be missing a couple of pretty key individuals up front. But for this Penguins team this year, it hasn't really mattered. They just fill in whoever's out with COVID with somebody else coming off of the COVID protocol, and they win hockey games, and they'd like to do that here again today.
All right, Razor, thanks for joining us. Have a great call this afternoon. And guys, if the Stars continue to play this way at home and then hopefully carrying that momentum on the road, it's going to mean good things to come in regard to the standings. Looking at the Western Conference as of now, Nashville and Vegas have been steady leaders in their respective divisions. Dallas chipping away toward a wild card spot. Hopefully the momentum from the last few wins can carry the Stars to a few more W's.
Yeah, you look in the short term, 3 points behind the Winnipeg Jets with a couple games, three games in hand. And then, of course, four behind those Edmonton Oilers that are in the wild spot. That's what you're looking at right now. Stars obviously want to be able to get higher, chip away at these games in hand, because this one today is going to be a beauty.
Well, all the teams ahead of Dallas in this chase, they're all playing over 500 hockey right now. So Dallas needs to keep pace, and they basically see Eastern teams for the next 3 weeks, except for St. Louis tomorrow, so they don't get head-to-head matchups to try and split this difference. They have to keep pace.
Well, guys, Thursday night, Braden Holtby was outstanding for the Dallas Stars. Tonight we find Jake Oettinger in net. It'll be his first start since December 20th. He's 7-2-0 on the season, and Brian, it will be great to see Otter back between the pipes in this one.
He loves playing at American Airlines Center, 7-1 this season, but for me, Sevy, it's rebound control. The Penguins love to attack the slot, the net front. You talked about their work below the dots. They generate the most rebound chances of any team in the National Hockey League, so the Stars need to be ready to box out, clear those chances, but for Jake Oettinger, absorb pucks or steer him to the corner, because that second chance can hurt you.
You know what's next to winning a Stanley Cup, Brian, as a young player?
What's that?
Being told you can get an apartment. And that is where he was. He's been told he could get an apartment. So all the nonsense he went through at the beginning of the year where he didn't know where he was going to stay, so important for him. He used this time off as a mini training camp. He talked about getting his skates underneath him to make him a little stronger. And then he also looks at power plays for other teams. He's going to need that tonight. Evan Rodriguez and, of course, Letang on the back end. That's Chris Letang. The defensemen are outstanding. So he's done a lot of video work on those two.
Well, a familiar face on the opposite end of the ice for the Stars. Tristan Jarry in net. They faced him back in October. Dallas with a shootout win in that one. But Tristan Jarry's been a huge piece of the Pens' recent success, Brian.
Well, they are the best penalty-killing team in the NHL, and he's a big reason why. You see the numbers right there this season. The goals against average and that save percentage, that is top three amongst goaltenders in the NHL. He's played the sixth most minutes. The big key is, can Dallas, Sevy, penetrate this defensive shell of the Pittsburgh Penguins? They're really good at suppressing shot opportunities for the opponent. If they can do that, get to that blue paint, find openings in the slot, they've got a chance here to bust out on Tristan Jarry. If they can't, they're going to have problems.
And guess what? He's no homer, right? He's got the best goals against in 13 road games, so obviously the Stars are going to have to be strong. And we talked about it. The first period, this team is so good in the first period. Obviously, a lot relies on their goaltending. Stars are going to have to find a way to get one early and get their their pace going.
Well, as Dallas and Pittsburgh meet for the final time this season, the first matchup was back in October. This could be a very different showing. This is a different time of the season for both of these teams. Brian, we could be in for a treat this afternoon.
Well, first of all, this game feels like it was ages ago, doesn't it? I mean, back in October, it's almost like it was last season, but the Stars were coming off back-to-back losses early in the year, and Lauren, as you said, it could be a much different showing today, Sebi. These are two different hockey teams today than they were in mid-October, and so whichever way it's going to go, it will be interesting to see between these two.
Yeah, the Stars really have a tough goal here to start, right? Obviously, Florida Panthers come into the barn the other game, and the Stars had to go head-to-head with them. They were four wins in a row. We got this team coming in, as you mentioned, 10-game heater, and then obviously we go to St. Louis, and they've been outstanding at home, so this is a tough three-game stand here for the Dallas Stars.
All right, guys, we're going to take a quick break, but when we return, we talk Jason Robertson and his home point streak as he looks to keep it rolling, and we get you set for puck drop coming up next.
Pavelski comes in and goes Fiveholski. The kid's been great. Ice in his veins in these. Walks in. Five-hole. Score! Stars are a Braden Holtby save away from ending it. Lundell tries to extend. Holtby save! Stars win!
Oh, man! Hockey at its best!
Welcome back to Stars Live. The Dallas Stars coming off of an exciting shootout win Thursday night and now look to carry that momentum into this afternoon as they host the Pittsburgh Penguins. But before puck drop, let's go up to the minute with Baylor Scott and White Health. We love when the Stars play at home. Dallas is 12-3-1 at American Airlines Center this season. Much success on home ice. And in their most recent three games after a five-game skid, the Stars have won their last three and now host the Penguins this afternoon, a team riding a 10-game win streak, currently the longest streak in the NHL. But as we know, guys, all good things must come to an end. And with the way the Stars have been able to grind it out and win here against some really tough teams, this has all the makings of a streak-ending game. What'd you say?
We've seen the Stars do this to a couple of teams already, but here's a stat for you. During the Penguins' 10-game win streak, they've trailed once. That's it. You've talked a lot about how good this team is starting. I feel like for Dallas, that first goal is crucial in this one tonight. Dallas needs to score first in this one, I think.
And I want to talk a little bit about overtimes, how well the Stars have done in overtime. Last year, they had 6 wins and 14 losses. Already, they have 6 wins in 8 games in overtime frame, so they're doing much better than that. That means they're winning the close games. And you know, the Stars just out of it last year in the playoffs by a little bit. Those points matter.
Speaking of streaks, Jason Robertson now has points in 5 consecutive games. He's on his third streak of the season where he's had points in 4 more consecutive games. And Sebi, he's only been held off the score sheet in just 6 of his 24 games played.
And you want to talk about a kid who's getting and being consistent. You see him on the ice early and on the ice late a lot of times, and he's working on things. He's a guy that is, I believe, a student of the game, and you could see it in his play. Working hard, and I love his ability in tight to get that shot off quickly. It's real important.
We were watching a morning skate before the Florida game. Derek Laxdal was talking with him after that morning skate, sort of teeing him up on the power play on that right wing side to sort of move downhill more, look for an opportunity to shoot the puck more. It is so sneaky and so lethal. If he can shoot the puck more, get a little greedier against this Penguins team that suppresses shots a lot, it makes Dallas more dangerous.
Well, on the opposite end of the ice, another guy that's been racking up points, Pittsburgh's Evan Rodriguez. It's been somewhat of a breakout season for the 28-year-old, Brian.
It's a great story. It really is. When you look at what he's done with 15 goals this year, but at the bottom, 34 in his previous 7 seasons combined. And for a guy who's about to be a UFA, Sebi, in a contract year, he's a worker bee. He does the dirty work in front for the Pittsburgh Penguins, especially on the power play. They generate rebound chances, and he's usually the one cleaning up those rebound chances.
And he's also got a little bit of shot. When you see the power play goals that he scores, you know, 4 of which come in the last 6 games, they're going to elevate him to that line with Crosby and Gensel. So those guys work together on the power play. They're going to be here at even strength. Again, just more firepower for this Pittsburgh Penguin team.
Sebi, Thursday night was fun. This one could potentially be even more fun. What are your final thoughts as we head into this matchup?
Yeah, I look around and I see a lot of black, right? right? Let's be honest. There's a lot of Pittsburgh people around here. I see a lot of Pittsburgh jerseys. We got to shut that down in a hurry. Let's get in and make sure the Stars can get that first goal and then work their magic from there. It's going to be real important.
I think we're going to use the phrase first goal a lot watching this first period just because of how vital it is. You pointed out the 17-1 difference in the first period that Pittsburgh's been doing to teams. Now all of a sudden, can Dallas get that first goal and put themselves in their own structure?
Brian, who's going to score the first goal tonight?
Oh, you know what? Why not my guy, Jason Robertson? I just said I wanted to shoot the puck more, so let's get that top line out there and let's let him snap one home.
I'm going to dig deep. Yanni Hockenbaugh is going to get the first one.
Woo, you dusted that one off, didn't you?
I'm going with Rope, guys. I'm going with Rope. The first of two weekend matinee games is minutes away. Stars and Penguins meet for the final time this season. Coming up next, Josh Bogorod, Razor, and Michelle McMahon have the call. This will be a fun one, y'all. For Brian Ray, Brent Severin, and the Stars Live crew, I'm Lauren Callender. We'll see you right here after the first period.
The Fan.
Coming back for more than 2 weeks off, the Stars were hoping to find success in their return. On Thursday night, that's exactly what they got. Puck at the other end of the ice, a shot, score! Klingberg let it rip from the line. Kept in, Sagan, backhand, score! The rookie for Florida, Lundell, turned aside, Holpe save, Stars win! Now they try to make it 2-for-2 coming out of the pause as they begin a back-to-back set of weekend matinees. Saturday afternoon, Stars Hockey presented by Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant, where today Dallas plays the middle game of a three-game week, and they host the hottest team in the league, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Hi, everybody. Good afternoon to you. Welcome to Stars Hockey alongside Daryl Ray. I'm Josh Bogorod. Stars returned from that long layoff, and the other night, it was another game in this building. Razor, another win in this building. They've got something special brewing at home.
Yeah, you know what they have? They have that confidence, that belief that when they come to their home rink, they're going to win. It's an expectation. Just look at the last 11 games here. The only loss, a 4-1 defeat to the Blues. They're averaging 4 goals a game. They've outscored the opposition by a whopping 14-4 in first periods. Robo's on a run as far as points are concerned here. And they've really erupted lately offensively. 16 goals in just the last 3 games at American Airlines Center. 5 of them on the power play, 1 of them shorthanded, lots of them at even strength. The top 2 lines are doing some serious damage right now. They're sprinkling in some defenseman goals. And the return of 91 into the scoring column again is a wonderful sight. The only caveat for me is the fact that if you look past these last 3 games, you look 4 games at home, they surrendered 16 goals on home ice. You got to trim that a bit.
Well, they've got a tough test tonight in the Pittsburgh Penguins, who haven't lost a game in over a month. And they've been dealt an awful lot of hurdles. One just a little bit before the start of this game. Doesn't really matter, Razor. They just keep rolling along.
Yeah, it doesn't matter where they play either. That's the thing. You know, they've won 10 in a row, 5 of those at home, 5 of those on the road. It's the longest win streak in the NHL this season. And, you know, there's no discernible weakness in their game. Goal production has been a real strength. Rodriguez and Rust have combined to score 12 of the team's 19 goals over their last 3 games. Might see some fireworks here today. Both notch hat tricks against San Jose. Evan Rodriguez likes to shoot a lot. He's tops on the Penguins in that regard. Potential big blow today, though. Brian Rust is out for COVID. Softening that, though, Jeff Carter returns off the COVID list. Hasn't played since the 19th of December. Did score 4 goals in 6 games prior to that.
Stars picked up a shootout win in their return to action on Thursday. We'll take a look at shootouts a little further in our spotlight, which comes your way right after this. Stars are working the day shift for the first of consecutive 1 p.m. starts this weekend. And right now, it's time for this afternoon's Shiner Box Spotlight.
The shootout studs. They won the last game and they won the game in Pittsburgh against the Penguins by being better in the shootout. Quartet of them, 40% or better in their Stars careers. This season, they haven't even deployed the best guy, Tyler Seguin. Joe Pavelski has been perfect this year. 3-for-3. Preschool teacher patients, different approaches, just deadly. The
kid, Jason Robertson, has shown a real flair for this as well, and he loves 5-hole. And if you go back to that game in Pittsburgh in October, Alexander Radulov ended it, patented backhand shove it. We salute you all.
That shootout win over Pittsburgh, all the way back, the fourth game of the season. But the two clubs meet again today for the second and final time this year. Opening faceoff is next. Begins at home early against the Penguins. We check out the matchup in net.
Jake Ottinger gets the afternoon assignment, and when he starts at home, the Stars usually win. Jake is 7-1 this season at American Airlines Center. Tristan Jarry sports the third stingiest goals against average in the league and has held opponents to two goals or fewer in each of his last seven starts.
Stars home team, they get the last change. They'll begin with the trio of Radek Foxa, Luke Glendening, Michael Roffel. Glendening awaits the opening faceoff against his number one line for the Penguins, Sidney Crosby, Jake Guentzel, and Evan Rodriguez. Pretty impressive what Pittsburgh's been able to do. 10-game winning streak with all the key guys out of the lineup. Still, they have some dangerous players you have to be aware of. Puck dropped at center ice. We are underway here at American Airlines Center, driven in by the Penguins. Second and final meeting this year between these two clubs. Foxa chasing after, trying to get a step on Dumoulin. He holds up, feeds Roffel with a shot, and that one goes wide. Roffel got Dallas on the board in the first game back from the pause on Thursday. He also got their only goal in a 2-1 shootout win back in October in Pittsburgh. Here's Jake Guentzel, trying to cross ice pass, deflected right back to him. Held in at the line by Dumoulin, who gets planted down on the check from Roffel, kept in Penguins, and a bouncing puck out in front of Ottinger, and redirected wide of the cage.
Started with a real strong play by Guentzel on the boards to get it to the front of the net.
Roffel to Foxa, shot turned aside by Jarry, and bounced off the back of the net. The Stars could not get it in front. They had Radek Foxa. Good action at both ends in the opening minute. Suter tosses back in from the red line. Dallas completes a change. Jarry on a platter for Marino. Penguins defenseman had Pittsburgh's lone goal in that first meeting. A lot has happened for both of these clubs on and off the ice since then. It was the fourth game of the year for both teams. The end of that season opening four-game road trip for Dallas. Here's Kasperi Kapanen. He'll feed it up high. Marino is shot. Redirected off traffic. There is Jeff Carter and his return to the lineup. Number 77 behind the net. Off for Dan Heinen. Stars take it away. They can't clear. Ottinger. Ended up the boards for Suter. He in turn finds Robertson. Hot pass bounced away from Pavelski.
They are not going to feel each other out here this afternoon. That's pretty obvious from the opening 2 minutes. Almost feels like it's going to be a sprint to see who can score first and then what happens after that.
Both teams were in action on Thursday night. The Stars playing their first game out of the 16-day break. They outlasted the Florida Panthers 6-5 in this building. It was the Penguins who took advantage of a depleted Flyers team, 6-2 in Philly, as the puck up and out of play.
Well, that good work down in the corner in the Star zone led to a little scramble and a pretty good look for Sidney Crosby in front. He's usually deadly on his backhand. Couldn't get a shot off, and then on the rush, speaking of guys on their backhand who can set people up, Michael Roffel's done that a lot, especially on the rush. A lot of it shorthanded, and he had Foxa dead in front. Good stop by Jarry on his first offering of the day.
Foxa has a couple of goals on the year. He has assists in his last two games, split by that two-week absence. Guentzel behind the cage, gets it with some space, walks out in front. He tried to feed it across to Crosby, couldn't connect. Held up high, Dumoulin over to Letang. Letang has been an assist machine this season, especially lately. His shot, though, gets blocked by Roffel all the way out. Penguins have played three games since they had a shutdown of their own, five games postponed, taking them right through the end of the 2021 calendar year. They picked up right where they left off before. 10-game winning streak, 7 before their pause, 3 coming out of it. Ben up high for Haskinen. His shot gets blocked. It was pressured all the way out by Bjorkqvist. These two former teammates, World Junior Championship for Team Finland. They're from the same hometown. Suter with the high flip to center. Pawing it ahead is Matheson. Guriana down the right side. Had a big night on Thursday. 3 points to lead everybody, a goal and two helpers. Out for Friedman. He will dump it in. Ottinger keeps it behind the cage. Friedman, traditionally a defenseman. He'll be playing a lot of forward in this game because of the COVID protocol. Additions to Brock McGinn.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how much he plays at forward. They always have the option to just double shift a winger. They don't play for a little while. They play out in California, so they can lay it all out there today.
There's McGinn and Rust, maybe the hottest player on the planet, who landed on the protocol list before the start of this one. They're still without Evgeny Malkin as well. Any game now, he should make his season debut after knee surgery in the offseason.
He skated here this morning. They might see him in Cali, I think.
Pedersen's pass. Nice catch by Kapanen. Had a step on Sekeru, recovered. Then a chance by Bluger. Punched aside Ottinger.
That's pretty transition there.
Back Aston Reese. Up for Letang. Drags it across the line. Looking for a lane. And deflected and calmly reaching up. Helps when you're big. Jake Ottinger extends and hangs up.
Well, there's a lot of pace to the game already here this afternoon, and quick transition up. Nobody's going to catch Kapanen if he gets that in stride. He had to stutter step for a second. Wise play to lay it back for center iceman Bluger, and a tester backhand in on Jake Ottinger. That is some hair. That's some flow he has going on. His dad, Sammy Kapanen, was a great player, played with the Hartford Whalers. The kid's got better jets than the old man.
Giveaway, and here's Rodriguez in the slot. Coming out to make the save on Ottinger. Rebound. He turned that aside as well from Letang.
Man, that is a spiffy stop on one of the hotter scorers in the league.
And he pounces on this rebound here. Yeah, not usually on that list, but Evan Rodriguez, what a season for him.
Erod in the slot after the Stars burp it up inside their own blue line. The Penguins quickly changed the point of attack, but that did not fool Ottinger, who held tight, and the elevated zinger from Rodriguez nailed him right in the clavicle, showed a quick clavicle. I think that puck was rolling a bit. Rodriguez probably didn't send it where he wanted to. Still a great stop by Ottinger.
It's the sixth NHL season for Evan Rodriguez. He had never scored more than 9 goals in a campaign. He's up to 15 already this year, still in the first half. Stars go to work on the other end. Good box out though, Matheson on Pavelski. Early shot advantage tilted heavily in favor of Pittsburgh. They've got 6 of the 7 shots on goal. Pavelski touches it, it's gonna be a hand pass. He delayed just long enough. And play continues as Dominic Simone hit it first. Ruedel around for Bluger. Ottinger waiting a slow moving puck. Now Klingberg. Gurianov ahead for Ben. Ben strides in, holds up, looks across, nothing there. Hand off Gurianov. Tight angle shot. Jari with the save. He hangs on.
Already seen Crosby and company in and around it offensively. Our Taco Bell take today. This is the 10th career game in Dallas for Crosby, and he is still looking for his first goal in Texas. Both of those stats are amazing, that it's only his 10th game and that he hasn't scored here. Chicago is the only other city where he hasn't tallied. And if you're wondering, Mario played 3 times in Dallas back in the day, Lemieux, and he scored in all 3 games.
Stars will try and hold him at bay for one more evening, or afternoon, I guess. Here's a shot as Haskinen hits traffic and hits the netting and out of play.
You know, you look at Crosby and you look at Tyler Seguin and where they rank on their teams in scoring right now. Of course, Sidney Crosby missed a ton of games, a dozen, coming off wrist surgery. He's 4th on the Penguins. Sagan's 8th on the Stars, but with a bullet, I'd say, right now.
Shot Gurianov. Stopped right before it got to Jari. Here's Crosby the other direction, looking for Gensel. Gensel has points in his last 16 games played. Letang to the left wing side. Here's a shot, score, Dumoulin. The Penguins just come out firing. 6 minutes and 2 seconds in, they finally pierce Ottinger. Early goal, Pittsburgh, they got a 1-0 lead.
First time we haven't seen the Fox line out there against them, and they left it wide open. Dumoulin, a defenseman, just creeps down the left wing side and sends a blistering wrister over the glove hand of Jake Ottinger. Severe angle. There was junk going on in front of the net between Haskinen and Crosby, and Ottinger just got beat. He got caught a little bit deep and maybe subtly off his angle, and the Penguins do open the scoring again.
Second goal of the year for Brian Dumoulin. When you win 10 games in a row, you're going to have an awful lot of impressive numbers and trends over that time. Maybe the most unbelievable that the Penguins have right now is on that 10-game winning streak. They now have outscored opponents 18-1 in the first period. The latest coming from Dumoulin, so the Stars will try and answer just as they did a couple nights ago. But advantage Pens early on here in Dallas.
The Stars trailing by one to the Penguins. Michelle McMahon here with you. He's not afraid to work on his weaknesses. This is the biggest distinguishing factor when it comes to the young goaltender, Jake Ottinger, according to the coaching staff. Jeffrey tells me a lot of guys at this level get embarrassed to work on their weak points, but not Jake. He is always willing to seek feedback on improvements. He handles himself well through adversity and is mature beyond his years. By the way, for much of the season, he's been living out of a hotel, guys, so he's been handling himself fairly well throughout this process.
Yeah, thanks, Michelle. He said he's excited. Got a little consistency. Here's a shot. Score! Kapanen in front, a redirection. Face-off win, Pittsburgh, and they turn it into offense immediately and double their lead.
This is how things got iffy. 6-on-5 the other night led to overtime in the ultimate victory in the shootout. This is just another wrister from the boards. What does it go off of? That in front of the net. Kapanen with a deft deflection as his stick was available. They sent two guys to the front of the net. John Klingberg was the only guy jockeying there, and that's how you get scored on. You give up the puck on the draw. The coverage is iffy in front of the net, and now it's a hole immediately for the Stars against the Pangs on home ice.
For all the trouble Dallas had with Florida and those opportunities early on Thursday, they never faced a multi-goal deficit. They were able, for a little bit of good fortune and puck bounces, and then clawing their way back to just keep it within one until they eventually went in front. Here they don't have that luxury. Still very early in the hockey game, but 2-0 Penguins. Klingberg in front, and a tip, and a good save by Jari on Radulov's redirection.
Was it ever?
Klingberg again, and this one got in on Jari quickly once more. Good shift and response for the Stars after the goal, but they can't keep the puck in at the line here. Suter, the turn, delays back in his own zone while Dallas completes a change. Stretched up for Foxa. He leaves it for Raffel. Raffel contacted by Gensel, knocked off, and now it's Rodriguez the other way. He finds Letang. Got another helper to his column. He assisted on the first goal, Dumoulin. And it bounces off the helmet of Foxa. Falls for Glendening, ahead for Raffel. Has a step. Raffel hit the glass as he was striking it on Jari. And Jari makes a save and hangs on to it.
Little bit of offensive epiphany out of the Stars here on this set coming off of the 2-0 goal. Kind of a spit it back at you. Right pad saved by Jari on the deflection from Radulov. Right in front. Good concentration. Got it with the bottom of the blocker. And then the B-way or partial B-way for Raffel. You watch the Penguins. They are in their three-quarter ice game, as they call it. It's basically top of the circles in their zone, down into the Stars' end. That has to stop. Dallas has to play in their end and deep for a bit.
I lift out to center. Sekera used the leg to kick it forward. Now Heinen. Matheson has a trailer. Kapanen shot. Save made by Ottinger.
Little button hook and then hit a late guy. When the Stars are on their game checking, sorting it out, going into their own zone, that shouldn't happen. Creative playmaking there, though, to generate another tester for Ottinger. Rick Bowness said that he saw his team game start around the third period the other night, against Florida after that lengthy, you know, break and pause because of COVID. And ultimately, they win it 6-5 in a shootout. But a lot of individuals were laboring to recover after shifts. They were trying to keep them short. Still parts of their team game was spotty at best, understandably. But you're not going to get away with it against these powerhouses of the Eastern Conference.
And in a situation, long layoff like that, it's not like you play one game and then you're right back to normal. There's concern as well for those lingering second, third games they're going to get today and tomorrow afternoon.
Win the one you're in. Don't worry about tomorrow.
Sekera holds it in at the point. Then he gets sealed off by Dumoulin. Gets the puck right back. Dumoulin got the scoring started. 6:02. 25 seconds later, it's Barry Kapanen. 2-0 Penguins. Here's Ruidel. He's pressured by Hintz. Threatened to walk around him. Couldn't take the puck with. Robertson back across the line, but it is offside against Dallas. Fans, Texas Rangers night is back by popular demand. Root for the home team and be at AAC on January 18th and see your Stars take on the Montreal Canadiens. Arrive early, you can see the Stars in special Rangers-themed warm-up sweaters. Secure your seats right now by visiting DallasStars.com.
Rangers have had a pretty good offseason as far as filling the roster once again.
Have they ever?
Question's going to be, where are they going to play?
Yeah.
Let's hope.
Whenever they do, they got quite the lineup. Dumped in by the Penguins. Ottinger. Leaving for Pavelski. Spun around. Dominic Simone. Short pass somehow eluded Robertson. Then a high shot. Load up on Pavelski. He wound up getting knocked down. Stars come away with possession. Miro Heiskanen played 26 minutes on Thursday night. Ahead for Lindell. Now Matheson inside the Pittsburgh line. Pressured by Joel Kiviranta. He was at the other end of the spectrum. 7-plus minutes in his first action since December 11th. Here's Peterson. Down the left wing. Peterson curls behind the net, past the reach of Matheson. One-timer by Klingberg. Turned aside and Kapanen on the counterattack. Three across the line for Pittsburgh. Kapanen got a pass through, out of the reach though of the cutting Matheson.
That's back-to-back with defensemen joining the attack. It was Klingberg at one end that just about clicked with the backdoor pass to a Penguin defenseman the other way. This is a slick, quick first period.
Already over halfway through it. Stars have, since falling behind, started to push a little more rubber towards Tristan Jarry. Haven't been able to get one past him yet. It's Klingberg. He'll bank it wide. Now on the near side. Nordqvist, fourth NHL game. He gets hit. Sekera's shot. Redirection by Glenn Denning. Turned it off target. Brian Boyle around for Pettersson. A flip. Akinpah with the glove, then the skates, then pressure. Fox are there for support. Dragging it up the left side wall, Raffle. With the free arm, is just trying to shield off Marino. In steps Boyle, and he'll bank it all the way down. This results in an icing against the Penguins. Now a message from Choctaw Casino and Resorts.
Stars are the best face-off team in the league, but Boyle and the Penguins are top 10 as well. Second goal was scored off a face-off. See if the Stars can return the favor here.
Face-off is claimed by Sagan. A low shot just missed the near post. Gurianov sends it around. Lindell. Now Ben. This line has been so productive. 11 points in their last two games. Before and then after the pause. Up by Lindell at the half wall. And escapes out to center. Long stretch pass. Dallas back in. Ben funnels it low for Sagan. He's ridden off. Gensel. Now Sidney Crosby. Dumoulin right back to Crosby. Nice catch through center. Rodriguez dropped for Gensel. Right dot. Shot blocked by Lindell. Held in the zone. Floater from the point. Missed the net. Raffle two hands it out to neutral ice.
Man, the Penguins are playing a nice team game with the puck and with movement and with one another, and especially this five-man unit.
Nearly a giveaway, and Rodriguez had to turn into more of a defenseman there than anything and just poke it away.
Their anticipation is terrific, though, and whether it's with the puck to one another or when something gets broken up. Somebody's right there, it seems like.
Suter weaves to center, then he'll chip. Matheson first on the scene. Speed of Hintz gave him some problems. Puck out in front. Stars couldn't find it. And boxed out in front of the crease. Joe Pavelski. Carter right on top of it practically. Suter. Nice reach and a glove by Robertson. Over to Pavelski. Stars are in. Back for Suter. A drive. Bounced off. Jari lingering rebound. Dallas couldn't get it. It's clear.
Done that a couple of times where they've been able to push into the zone and then bump back to the D. More of that, please, I'm sure, is the refrain on the Stars bench.
Friedman around for Simone. Short pass. Here's Marino. He'll stride through center across the Dallas line. Too many green sweaters there. Keeps it alive down behind the net. Simone centering feed. Rod on it. Makes its way to Bluger. Then a cross up high. Friedman, Marino. Back to Friedman. One-timer. Missed wide. Big bounce back to the near side.
It's plays like that, though. A big miss on the end board, but somebody's anticipating where that puck is going to end up, and they get there first. One way of playing really fast as a team.
Poked along the wall. Held in just inside the Dallas blue. Stenson shifts. Stars Peterson. He gets hit by Aston Reese. Down to a knee. Chopped by Klingberg. Simone had it. He'll feed it up high. Penguins keep possession. Get some fresh legs in the process. They'll spin it around. Sekera tried to reverse it. Klingberg is out of gas. He'll set up a roadblock on the wall. Penguins have the Stars in trouble. It's Letang. Side to side. Crosby let it go through. Here's a shot and a save by Andre. They needed one. And Andre provides it on Gensel. Shade under six to go in the first. Penguins have the first two goals of the afternoon. Dallas in a 2-0 hole hosting Pittsburgh.
By Jake Oettinger. Comes into the high slot, finds it, and zings it right into the torso of Oettinger. Our Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant marquee matchup. He and Hintz are in their element here today. Roope Hintz with 11 goals on home ice, ranked 7th in the league. Gensel, 14 goals on the road. Only Mangiapane and Dreisaitl have scored more in the entire National Hockey League.
Premature faceoff. You were talking about this pregame. It really is just, it's so impressive what Pittsburgh has done away from home ice. What they have done this season, what they've done with guys out of the lineup.
Well, I give a lot of credit to the guy in behind the bench, yeah. Too, you know. They are a well-prepared club. Mike Sullivan and his staff have done great work.
Dumoulin sends it to the corner. Niskanen on the reach by Foxa. Raffle across the line, though. It is offside against Dallas.
Yeah, Mike Sullivan was preparing to coach Team USA at the Winter Olympics, along with guiding these Penguins through injuries and COVID. And then, of course, the NHL not participating in China next month. His teams have always played fast and extremely structured. You have to have the horses, too, yes. But he seems to put them in real good spots, and they play a wonderful, fast team game.
Stars have seen that so far through 14 and a half minutes. In the Dallas zone, puck along the corner. Ben and Carter. Down near the line. Dumoulin, he'll send it wide. Let's Carter go back to work, this time in the opposite corner. Tapping in with a poke. Gets past Letang. He's pursued by Gurianov, who can get there quickly and did.
Letang with that mobility, though, he turned against the grain, saw Tyler Seguin supporting Gurianov, so just swerves the other way. Pucks down the ice, they get their full change in. There's no substitute for mobile defensemen in today's game.
Even in his 16th NHL season, Chris Letang, what a year he's having. Another assist tonight. Third among all defensemen in that category. Here's Miro Heiskanen. Put it right off of Pettersson. Pettersson will chip it around for Rodriguez. Pettersson back to Rodriguez. A curve across the line. Along the near side boards, rims it. Blueger, Aston Reese, a shot gloved by Ottinger. He will hang on to it there. Remains 2-0. Pittsburgh plays the first period here in Dallas.
Inside American Airlines Center, all the fireworks on the Penguin side as they lead the Stars 2-0. Not many teams have come in here and been successful this season. The Stars' first 16 games, this is the third best opening 16 games on home ice in Dallas Stars history. Those other 2 years, I mean, 99, they won the Cup. In 03, 02, 03, they probably should have won the Cup. Stars, though, have to do what those two teams did, and that's win on the road a little more often than they have.
Lindberg the chip, jumping, spiking it forward. Matheson, now Sekera. Gurianov. Blueger races back. He's got plenty of time and space. He'll bank it around. Klingberg run into by Simone. It goes over to Sekera and then passed away from Gurianov. Game has leveled out a little bit since the two goals less than half a minute apart from Pittsburgh in terms of chances, possession, shots. But certainly the scoreboard reflects a great start that Pittsburgh got out to here in this daytime.
Well, they're still dictating this game. They're playing faster than the Stars have been able to giddy up this afternoon so far, as that puck went up over the Stars bench and out of play. And, you know, we've seen this before with the Stars, where they've had some opening periods, maybe not in this last stretch, but certainly early in the season here on home ice, where they really looked like they had their game going, and then they get it going in the second period. And this might be another day where, if they can just get through this first period with not too much damage against, fight their way back into it.
Ben's back on the attack. It's Heinen. Gets it written into the boards by Pavelski. Carter there. First game back. He actually came off the COVID protocol list on Wednesday. Penguins had games Wednesday and Thursday, but he was symptomatic. He was held out of those two as well, ready to go here today. Shot blocked and then deflected. Lope Hintz is able to clear it out. Stars, if they get there, could have numbers. Robertson, a race with Letang. They cancel out. By the time Pavelski got there, there wasn't much of an angle.
That's the thing. Like, they have defending speed as well as attacking speed. Another puck up and out of play. You know, the Stars do have guys that can gallop, and they can play fast, but they're having a tough time getting ahead of the Penguins repeatedly here in the early going. It's not for lack of trying, but when it looks like there's a, you know, a sprint break, all of a sudden it gets closed and there's nothing from it.
Stars were able to generate offense right off the faceoffs on Thursday, an offensive zone draw here, but it's the Penguins who control it. One of the two goals they've scored in the game came immediately off of a draw. Box up, kicked it away from Crosby. Perimeter battle deep in Dallas territory. Chipped out to the Penguins line. First on the scene is Friedman. Now Lindell. Dallas has to touch back up. As they do, they'll just elect to complete a change. Peterson, Radulov, Kiviranta to trio out for Rick Bonus. Brian Boyle will chip it in. Big week for the Boyle family. Welcomed a baby boy a week ago. Shot deflected, stopped in the slot. Grabbed back by Hagenpah. Got it out of harm's way, but not out of the zone. Boyle will send it around. Marino awaits. Off the stick of Sekera. He got the position on Boyle, then took a shot along the wall. Hagenpah steps in. Room for him to skate it to neutral ice. He was behind the red line, though. So that's icing. All he had to do was take another half-second beat, would have gotten to the line. He'll have to stay out there with the rest of his teammates.
Yeah, that's just a mental error. one more stride and he's over center and in. Instead, another one of these attack zone faceoffs. Immediately, you saw the next line hop over the boards for the Penguins. I anticipated it was going to be 87 and company, but it wasn't.
That Bluger to take the draw against Peterson. It's no small footnote. They can't change. Hockeypaw's been out there a minute 20. He gets a reprieve after a faceoff win. Banks it this time and get to the bench fresh legs. So winds up being much ado about nothing. Final 80 seconds of this opening period. Stars on the attack. Here's Klingberg. Five straight games with points for him. He will play keep away from Aston Reese. Over to Ben, back to Klingberg. Could not stick handle his way through the left wing circle. Grabbed by Simone. Out for Bluger. The lift falls off the glass into the Stars' end.
It was kind of a risky flop out of the zone. It came close going over the glass. It would have been a penalty. Although I don't know that anything's a risk when they take penalties. It's the number one PK in the league.
Last time these two teams met, there wasn't a power play in the game for either side. 0-0. The only penalties were matching minors back in the third period between Glendening and Zucker. One of the many Penguins not in the lineup here this afternoon. Gensel. He's hit by Pavelski. Bounces up to the left wing side. Dumoulin and now Crosby.
And that support is always there.
Shot saved by Andre and Dumoulin. 10 seconds left in the period. Comes free to Klingberg. Not much time to do anything, so he's content to take a knee and we will head into the locker room. 2-0. Penguins have the lead. The goals, Dumoulin and Campbell. Happening after 20 in the books.
Yeah, well, there's no question they were the better team in the first 20 minutes. The question now is, will Ottinger and company get a little more comfortable and better as it moves along? Remember, Jake Ottinger hasn't played since before the pause, too, and he looked like inactivity was not his mate in that opening period, too.
Crosby and company in town for the only time this season. It's a pair of goals 25 seconds apart that has Pittsburgh on top. We're one third of the way through here on a Saturday afternoon in Dallas. 2-0 Penguins. First intermission report is next. Welcome you back in. 20 minutes in the books and heading into this game, Razor. The Stars knew they had a tough test on paper and they saw exactly why in that opening frame.
They did. I mean, they're going to earn their opportunities to score in the game here this afternoon. And they did have some chances. I'm sure that was what was being sold a bit in the Stars dressing room between periods. You know, stop what's going on at the other end, but they did have opportunities to get on the board themselves. A lot of it individualistic and unfortunately just one at a time, and that might not get it done against Tristan Jarry and this Penguin team. Jarry's had a real workhorse run of two seasons, and they stuck with him. There were people screaming for a new starting goaltender after his performance, which was subpar in the playoffs, but they showed belief and he has rewarded that belief this season. He's been brilliant.
Perfect. 7 of 7 so far at the other end. Jake Ottinger stopped 9 of 11 he's seen in his 2022 debut. Early penalty upcoming. The Stars touch the puck behind the net just 10 seconds in. We see a power play on either side back in the first meeting or the first period of this one, but Stars go to the box. Yanni Hakanpää.
Dallas number 2, 2 minutes of interference.
Gotta love the stripes. They just absorb the verbal abuse, castigated on their way into the box, and then announce it, away you go. So interference deep in the Dallas zone, and this is a power play that is usually kinetic. Lots of movement of people and the puck, and Letang is kind of their go-to guy as far as fingers on most of their offense when they're up a man.
So Stars, big 2 minutes here in a 2-0 hole. Start of the second period. Down a man on the ice. Esa Lindell bumps it up ahead. And cleared just off of Crosby and out to center. Penguins' power play is 18%, 22nd overall this season, but on their 10-game winning streak, they're much better than that, just under 30%. Elden off the line. Rodriguez over to Carter. Got through Crosby. Nice play to get it back to Carter, and a shot saved by Ottinger. Boxa drops it to the sidewall. Haskin in there as well. Out to the line. Letang holds it in. They'll move it to Crosby. Quickly, Rodriguez. Shot save. Ottinger. Rodriguez didn't get everything on it.
That's twice he's had opportunities, and I don't think has struck with the shot that he wanted early in the first period with that wrister and that one-timer there on a zip pass from the other side of the ice.
Talked about Rodriguez's goal scoring earlier in the game. He's got 6 on the power play. Only had 7 his entire career heading into this season on the power play. Here's Letang. Across, couldn't get through. Letang holds it in. 40 seconds left on the power play. Diving by Foxa. He can't get it, but he pressured Letang. The Stars are clear. Through the first 90 seconds of this 2-minute power play with Hakanpaa in the box for interference. Personnel changes on both sides as Matheson slowly out of his zone, a drop for Heinen. He'll accelerate through center ice. Look for Marino. Bit out of his reach. Secker a chance to steal. Tied up along the wall. Wrapped around to the far side. Dominic Simone. Poke to the line, not out. Marino shot it right off of the skates of Secker.
That's the buried head slap shot right in. Shin pad assassin, if you will. Never looked up.
Hakanpaa comes free. Stars 1-for-1 on the kill. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Suter circles behind the cage, chased by Bluger. Hakanpaa tosses in.
Looking at two plays in particular that, you know, you look back at the end of the game and say, well, that was pretty important. This kill right here, and that save by Jake Ottinger on Gensel when it was 2-0, and it could have gone to 3-0, and then you're in major, major trouble. So we'll see where this thing meanders the rest of the way.
Reached by Haskin, trying to keep it in to Sagan. Now Gurionov, and he was sandwiched by Penguins. Klingberg a shot. Around it comes to Haskin. Stars dump back in. Jari wants to keep the moving quickly. Crosby the bank pass off the boards in front of the Dallas bench. Pile up there, and Crosby emerges with possession. 1-on-3. They'll find Dumoulin. Dumoulin just keeps it wide, rims it around. Shot by Radulov. Gensel's got it. Now up high, Dumoulin, one of the two goal scorers. Hand off for Friedman. Back for Dumoulin. Shot through the slot and one.
Just looking for Crosby's stick in the high slot there, and just about.
Star steal, Peterson, Nikita Ranta. He's pestered all the way through center. Finds Peterson. First shot off target. Radulov spun it back low. Marcus Pettersson. Gensel, soft chip, change for Pittsburgh.
They've just been unable thus far to get the Penguins out of sorts in their own zone. There's been no chaos really down there. They've been in control. Get it in behind them, get on the forecheck, do it quick, and do it in concert with one another and work from that. Sounds easy from here.
See what they do downstairs. Is Pavelski out of the corner pass. Came right back to him on the intercept. Hakanpaa. Pettersson behind the net. Kasperi capping it. Elects to keep it on his stick. Now a handoff for Carter. He's got Heinen with his shot. Trickles through the slot and wide. Star steal once again. Robertson to Pavelski. Top line for Dallas. Finishing up their change. They head to the bench. Underneath him come the Ben Sagan, Gurionov trio. Bouncing puck, held inside the Star zone, Aston Reese. Goes low for Simone. Already more than 5 minutes into the second period. Dumoulin couldn't keep it inside the line, so the Penguins have to touch up. It gives Jamie Benn plenty of time. Stars captain has back-to-back goal and assist games. albeit separated by 2.5 weeks. Suter, steal it away from Simone. Ruidel, across for Dumoulin. Didn't like the look. Continues the game of catch with Ruidel. Now off the stick of Bluger from center. Short hopper in on up. Another reach for Foxa. This will not have enough legs for icing. Play goes on. Pettersson. Put it up into the Stars bench. That's out of play. No delay of game if it winds up in the bench from the defensive zone. But we will step aside. Second and final meeting this year between the Stars and Penguins, and approaching the midway point of the game. It's 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Talk Casino and Resort Durant. Stars behind the Penguins 2-0 in the second period today at American Airlines Center. And this is a Penguins team that's doing virtually everything right now. They're on a 10-game winning streak. There's no area of pause for them right now. Offense, defense, special teams.
Adell shot saved by Jari. He hangs on to it.
The fifth longest winning streak in their rich franchise history. And it's a Penguins club that's recently sold. Went for close to $1 billion. FSG Fenway Sports Group purchased them. Mario Lemieux still involved. More on Mario Lemieux later today. He's vowed, though, to remain active and engaged with them. Why not?
One of the greater stories of this generation of hockey and how he saved the franchise in more ways than one. Here's Guentzel. Cross for Pettersson. Shot! Redirection. Rodriguez clanked off the post. Odger gets the glove on it, and the Stars dodge a huge one.
I would suspect that this is a product of playing with Sidney Crosby, because Crosby might be the best at doing what Rodriguez just did. Make your stick available off to the flank of the net and just angle your stick and deflect it up high against the grain on Ottinger. Never got square to that one. Had him beat on the far side. They really only had pipe, but they dodged one there.
Right off the draw, shot saved by Ottinger. He hung on to this one from Matheson. This second period is 6.5 minutes old. Stars only have the one shot on goal, and Ottinger's having to keep a minute here.
Well, rebound control is going to be an asset for Ottinger in his career. It already is when he's really on his game. There's not a lot of second opportunities out in front. Smart, hardworking young netminder.
Jason Robertson, pass ahead. Good touch. Here comes Hintz. He's got a step, and he missed the net. He was looking up high.
That's the first appearance really in the game of the Stars' top line.
I've shown before that they can strike quickly. It doesn't take a whole lot. And offside here, Heinen. What a terrific opportunity for one of the best in green.
Well, they're so good at this, the relay play, and all three forwards on that line involved in it. It's Robertson from his own zone, Pavelski at center, and they hit Hintz on the gallop. And when he's striding down the wing like that, nobody's going to catch him. Just too much air underneath of it, trying to go cookie jar on Jari.
Bluger against Pettersson, just outside the Stars' line. A little bit of a warning. Redo it. Faceoff is fought for. Radulov just trying to push ahead. Instead, it's the Penguins who can deliver it in deep. Bouncing puck is a tough one for Ottinger behind the net. Stars come away and in front of the bench. Contact cancels, moves over to Klingberg. Across Radulov. No shot, flipped the corner of the crease and went wide. Klingberg trying to feed the slot again. He was intercepted and cleared.
That's better. The last couple of times the Stars have hit the Penguins blue line with purpose. Pushed them back a little bit.
Radulov. He's down across the blue line. Stars get in deep, Secker, the defenseman, but he gets separated from possession by Simone. Austin Reese, he's slowed down by Pettersson. Tigurianov, fresh off the bench. Tight angle, and open play back to Ben, who got a quick shot away. Klingberg, nice slip pass. Gurionov, a shot, rolls off Jory, lost sight of it, loose for a moment. Then he winds up with it. Ben winds up on top of him and throwing punches away from the play. A couple of guys get wrestled down to the ice.
Well, it's taken them 28 minutes to fully get some of this into. I think they need this today against the Penguins. You know, a little bit of emotion. Get this crowd involved in this today and get on their game in the attacking zone. Double set up in front of the net in both Ben and Radulov. Alexander getting a shift up the lineup, if you will, and they force Jari and the Penguins to scramble a little bit. Unfortunately, out of it, there's a minor penalty on the Star side of things. Now they got them both. There you go. See where this goes from there. I mean, they vowed coming out of the COVID pause that they were going to be harder at both nets. They were kind of soft in front of their own net in the first period. They haven't really appeared until recently in front of the Penguins net. And I'm sure Rick Bowness has harped on that here this afternoon. More of that. Steady diet of that if they can. See if they can pop the goose egg on Jari.
See what 4-on-4 provides. Matching minors for roughing against Alexander Radulov and Mark Friedman. The Stars four out there to begin. Offensive zone. It's Glendening and Foxa with Haskinen and Lindell. Penguins win the draw. Letang and Dumoulin in the defense. Pink Crosby and Gensel. They're the forwards. Plenty of ice out there. Each team down a man. Stretch pass ahead for Crosby. Measured by Haskin. There's Letang with it to the left dot. Puck on a string like it normally is. Over to Dumoulin. Taking the wide route on Foxa. Crosby trying to shake Haskinen. Possession still for Pittsburgh. Good moves at the point by Letang. Inside out on Foxa.
No fear.
Foxa never let him free, but the puck stays in his zone. Gensel with a shot. Blocked by Lindell in the corner. Dumoulin for Crosby. Been walking that line just inside the blue, but a lot of sustained time. Now it's turned over to Dallas. Glendening the other way. Foxa to the bench. Partial change. Glendening turning wide, and he gets bumped down and slides into the inboard. 45 seconds left in the 4-on-4. Dallas with some fresh legs out there. Tyler Seguin, Roope Hintz, the forwards. Bumped it ahead, though, Rodriguez. He's joined by a couple of teammates across the Dallas line. Rodriguez, a shot saved by Ottinger. Here's Hintz. Through center. Leaves it for Seguin. In front, Hintz got a stick on it. Jari holds his ground. The Stars were digging for that puck, and now Hintz all tied up with Rodriguez.
It's infectious, and Alexander Radulov got it started. And now all of a sudden the Stars have a little bee in their bonnet around the opposing net. I mean, that's how you score. You have to have emotion and drive and boxy in your game. Good work by Tristan Jari to multitask in his short game right in front of the net. That was a nice setup by Seguin to Hintz in front of the net, using some speed, a little open ice with fewer player on both sides. Usually it just turns into a nothing fest for 2 minutes, but it's been fairly active here between these two teams and still 19 seconds remaining in it.
Ben and Gurionov, offensive zone face-off. Suter and Klingberg round out the quartet behind him.
Smart move.
And it is controlled initially by the Penguins, inched across the line. Stars have to touch up.
You see what Jamie was trying to conduct there, where when to draw back to Suter, he had Klingberg way off on the right side. If they could win it, get it across, he'd have a lane to the net.
Out of the box come Friedman and Radulov. 4-on-4 gives way to 5-on-5, but not for long. Delayed penalty upcoming, this time against the Penguins. Ottinger goes to the bench. Extra attacker out there for Dallas. Klingberg through center for Ben. Stick handles wide. Now Pavelski sent to the cross. Stars set up. It's Klingberg. Over to Ben. Right circle. Delays. Feeds it Klingberg. One-timer blocked right back to him. And eventually touched. That brings the whistle. Halfway through the game, Stars trail by two, but they're going to go on their first power play of the afternoon. Teddy Bluger to the box for taking down Klingberg.
A key matchup this afternoon, the best road penalty killing in the league against the number two power play at home. The Leafs are better than the Stars percentage-wise. 30%, 31% against 90%. Normally, you'd look at a game like this, you'd think, Stars, you can't rely on your power play for your offense, but it can unclog them, perhaps, and especially if they can dent this top penalty kill in the league. So this is a big, big moment in the game.
Krawczyk in the call against Bluger, Pavelski, Robertson, Radulov, Hintz, and Klingberg, the unit. Shot from Klingberg, couldn't get through, kept alive by Dallas. Right back to the top of the zone, Klingberg. Over to Hintz. Klingberg once again. Feeds Robertson right dot. Up high for Klingberg. Dragging it with him to Robertson. Shot, redirection. Radulov through the legs of Jari, but wide of the net. He went to the backhand. Robertson's shot gets blocked. Alexander Radulov, what a chance, still sitting on surprisingly just the one goal this season.
Well, that would have been poetic because he kind of got things started for the Stars here. He had him beat, he just threw it out the other side.
Dallas was caught offside, so they had to let the puck go, change up in the process. 50 seconds into this power play. Early into the second half of the hockey game. The two Penguins goals both came back in the first, both even strength. Klingberg's feed. Now Pavelski. Tyler Seguin down into the corner. Around it goes, Klingberg. Trying to keep alive away from Carter. Stopped by Seguin, he'll hustle to the puck, find Ben. Jamie Benn leaves it for Klingberg up high once again. A wrist shot and deflects to the far side, a reload, Seguin to Klingberg, back for Seguin. Fed it to the slot, and then out of midair, kept by Klingberg, touched by Carter, and now a penalty is coming. They're gonna get Klingberg for taking down Carter. Klingberg irate at the call, interference against him, and that'll erase the final 20 seconds of the Dallas power play.
Go back to the opportunity for Alexander Radulov in front of the net. He's shoving off a Dumoulin to give himself some space. Gets it to the back and throws it right through the legs. You know, full split from Jari. Had to do it quick and it goes out the other side by about 6 inches. The penalty is after Klingberg knocked the puck down above his shoulders and that was going to kill the play. He interferes, steps out of his lane and then rips into the referee as he makes his way into forced confinement. So we have seen some penalties here today with these two clubs, and that'll do it for the Stars' opening salvo on the power play.
It's the second bout of 4-on-4, this one for much shorter. They traded chances, no goals on 2 minutes earlier this period. Haskinen through center, across the line, feed for Glendening. Held in by Suter, down the right wing side. Trying to get one through to Glendening. Fox follows to the slot, and they say played with a high stick. Fox disagrees, he was in a prime spot for that puck to fall to him.
Well, the referee was only about 15 feet away from him, so he had a good view. Whether Fox had dipped down or not, everybody wants to watch it on the big screen again. There's no question it was above Glendening's head when it was contacted. I think the question was, did it get kicked first by a Penguin, touch a Penguin, and then Radek Fox? But it happened so quick. They don't get the luxury of slow motion replay like we do and everyone watching.
And that look, it Appears like they did get the right call. Bluger comes out of the box. It's cleared all the way down. So power play two begins for the Penguins. Jari goes on an adventure in front of the net.
He stared at the referee like he got tripped up by Raffle.
Here's Crosby. Plenty of time for Pittsburgh to work. But no one home at the right point. Letang has to chase it back.
Yeah, Carter was anticipating that he would be there.
Letang, the puck carrier. Missed drop pass for Guentzel, and Pittsburgh power play can't get out of neutral. They've got a minute to go on it. Rodriguez sends it across to Guentzel. Now they're in. It's Carter, a shot. Bounced over to Rodriguez. Fed it dangerously out in front. Glendening will race the other way shorthanded. One-on-one. Forced wide by Letang. Just slows it up. Chooses work on the clock. Jeff Carter through center for Rodriguez. Spins his way across the Dallas line. Ottinger got a piece to slow it down. Reverse by Lindell. And Hakanpää pokes it up the boards. Not clear. Blind pass by Heinen. Tapping in there. 23 seconds left on the power play for Pittsburgh. Pope near the slot. Raffle jumps on it. Stick handles his way through Marino. Got it out to center. Heinen, one last chance for the Pens. Drop for Simone. In front, clanked off the heels of Heinen. Klingberg will rejoin as Pavelski skates through center, holds up. Stars are through another one. Nice move. Ben, a low shot turned aside by Jari.
A nice delay play by Pavelski, understanding the clock and positioning of his teammates. Jamie Benn came close.
So 0 for 2 on the power play is Pittsburgh.
And they haven't really threatened when they've been up a man. A little cute. I think they believe they can pass their way into the net.
8 power play goals, accounting for the 45 total on the 10-game winning streak.
They just look like they feel and believe that they can check their way to victory with a 2-goal lead here. We're going to find out whether that's true or not.
Haskin weaves it in for Suter. A shot stopped off Jari, and then behind the net, it's Robertson. Centering pass goes off a stick. Suter gets moved, and it's clear.
Normally, you'd say that's kind of a dangerous way to play, especially on the road. How are you going to argue with what they've done on the road lately? Stars are starting to push a little, though.
Gurianov. Now Peterson. Back for Gurianov. Pass was behind him. Here come the Penguins. Rodriguez chips. Surrounded by 3 green sweaters. Follows it to the corner. Comes out off the side of the cage. Crosby. Through his legs. Backhand. No connection there. And the Stars. Their turn to race. Gurianov trying to feed Peterson. Comes back to him and he scores! There's the breakthrough for Denis Gurianov, who stays hot and cuts the Dallas deficit in half.
Well, they gave up an unnecessary odd man rush against, and it's a broken play. Friedman's back there. It's blocked up, but it goes right back into the wheelhouse of Denis Gurianov. The one thing I wish Gurianov would do more of is drive the slot. You know, it's a fortunate play, but if he would do that more, I think he'd score more. I think he'd create more chaos. I think he'd draw more calls. That one put the Stars on the board, saws the lead in half, and changes the complexion of this game late in the second.
It was the Stars' leading goal scorer a couple of years ago in the first of what was a couple of COVID-shortened seasons. That's his 6th of this year, and it's everything that the Stars were hoping they would find out of him these last 3 games. 2 assist game heading into the pause, a goal and 2 assists coming out of it, and then a goal here this afternoon. It could be a key one if there's a push behind it from Dallas. The Penguins, though, trying to answer right back. They've got the puck in the attack zone. It's Barry Kapanen behind the net. Heinen. They feed it to Ruidel. Up at the line. High shot. Bounces off the back glass. Now Matheson. Andrei Sekera. edge of the trapezoid. He's tied up along the baseboards. And threatening to crawl out in front. Good stick position by Ottinger. Just keeps it behind the net. Stars not out of trouble yet, though. Pressure to a turnover. Bluger, a chance. Save Ottinger. Rebound is loose in the slot. And Ottinger never had it covered, but the whistle blown. The Penguins protest. A bit of a scare in the star zone. But they've got the recent tally from Gurianov, and they've made it a one-goal game.
We're late in the second period. Stars down 2-1 to the Penguins on home ice. And the Penguins, off of that goal given up, came into the Stars zone a little bargy. Almost crammed, bludgeoned a puck past Ottinger and company. Kept it out. Jake's been fine. You know those two goals went 30 seconds apart in the first period. Both of them, I believe, when he's really sharp, don't go in. They just don't. Not all on him, but he's given them nothing since.
Crosby face-off win, Letang to Dumoulin. And Gensel's shot gets blocked by Lindell. Gensel sends it around. Letang drifts low. Beats Crosby, up high Dumoulin. One-time Rodriguez in a shot, turned aside by Ottinger.
It's a good battle within the game today, Rodriguez and Otter.
There's Lindell, feeds it to the left wing side. Jari with the save, juggled it for a bit, and then hangs on. Now a message from Jack Daniels.
Another real spiffy stop by Ottinger on Rodriguez, who has, you know, some testers who also hit a pipe earlier in this second period. He shoots a lot. He leads them in shots on goal.
Roberts into Haskin and shot, and a glove save up by his left ear for Tristan Jarry.
Well, Miro Haskinen has the skill set to impact games every single shift offensively, and they bring a forward up top, run the umbrella, and I like it when Miro shoots, but I also like it whenever Miro Haskinen takes it to the net, because he's so deceptive with the puck. Good snappy save by Jari on him there.
Heinen shoots in from center. Haskinen going to the end boards. Collision spins Carter around as Pavelski got him. Two longtime veterans coming together. Roope Hanch trying to turn the corner. Holds up, looking for help. Just feeds it across, open space. The Stars jump on it. Looking for an equalizer. Pavelski shot, saved by Jari. Jason Robertson slipped to Pavelski. Shot blocked again in front, nicely by Pettersson. Marino mishandles in front of the Dallas bench, and then second effort winds up about 10 rows deep.
This is really good for the Stars. They've kind of nudged the Penguins out of their comfort zone. It's not an easy game for Pittsburgh now. Some of that has been physicality. Some has been the ability to get in the offensive zone and work their forecheck, lean on their D a little bit. Very different game here as the second period has moved along than what we witnessed in the first. That was dictated by the Penguins.
John Klingberg for Gurianov, who's got the Stars tally. Given away, though, and it's a delayed offside as Aston Reese was
the most delayed offside.
He was coming in all alone, had no idea.
You're watching that and you're like, that can't be, because Klingberg and Gurianov were next to one another, kind of just stopped on it, understanding it was hockey's version of the free play.
Bluger and Sagan face off, win Dallas. 70 seconds left in the middle period. Penguins got two in the first. Stars have the lone one here in the second. Jamie Benn, nice move across the line to the slot, stays with it. Cut across for Sagan. The pressure. Now Ben. Matheson came over from Florida in the Patrick Hornquist trade a couple seasons ago.
Penguins have just looked more casual here in the second period with the puck in their own zone and some of their movement. And the Stars now have some snarl in their game.
Certainly a different feel. The score line matches. Fox sets to Sekera. Off the stick of Raffle. Glove down by Dumoulin. There's Rodriguez. Sends it across. Jake Gensel. Back for Dumoulin. Tipped off the glass. Around it goes. 5 seconds left in the frame. Pass for Gensel. Got through him. He'll feed the slot. It'll wind up on the far side. Bouncing puck and not much Letang could do with a buzzer beater attempt. And that's how the second comes to a close.
Well, they finally dented Jari Gurianov with a pretty mammoth goal, you would think, in this middle frame. And this feels like a game in the balance now. After the first period, it did not.
20 to go. Still work to do for Dallas. Stars had some close calls. Penguins kept trying to extend the lead. Gurianov, sixth of the year from Jacob Peterson. And Jason Robertson, who extends his home point streak to 10 games, has Dallas within a goal. Second intermission report coming up next.
By Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant. Expansion now open. Stakes raised. By Baylor Scott & White Health. Changing healthcare for the better. By Chevrolet. Chevy drives Texas. Find new roads. And by CarShield. CarShield cars go farther.
Fans, keep up with all the action by following the Stars on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook for the latest team news, score updates, contests, and exclusive behind-the-scenes content. And for more must-see Stars videos, don't forget to follow us on TikTok. Welcome back. 40 minutes in the books here on this Saturday afternoon. And Razor, we got ourselves a hockey game.
Yeah, I felt like the shift from Radulov woke the game up a bit, and the goal from Gurianov, potentially a real big one. And, you know, speaking of offense, our Blue Cross Blue Shield legends of the game, yeah, offense was what Mario Lemieux was all about back in the day. Went first overall in 84, just ahead of me, by the way. Hardware galore in his career, 3 MVPs, 6 scoring titles. He had back trouble that he fought through, and also a bout with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. But at the end of his career, he posted the second best points per game in NHL history, in behind only the great one, Wayne Gretzky. Still gonna...
What an absolute incredible pass of the baton for that franchise from Mario to Sid. Crosby and company right now have a 2-1 lead. The Stars had their best sequence of play there late in the second period. The only goal of that middle frame, and looking for a comeback, trying to halt the longest winning streak in the NHL. The Penguins at 10 games is 5 seconds into this third. The puck is up and out of play. Offensive zone face-off for the Stars as Fox up, matching up against Crosby. Crosby wins it, back to Letang. Over to Gensel. Gensel assisted on that first goal back in the opening period, scored by Dumoulin. He now has points in 17 consecutive games. Stretch dates back to the middle of November. He missed a few games over that stretch with injury, so officially the NHL stops counting it among the league leaders with point streaks, but he's in the lineup. He's on the score sheet basically every night. Raffle spun around, trying to stay with it. And Fox up, gets it around, a reach of Hakanpaa, 6-6, and he needed to be. He held it in, but his momentum carried him to the other side of the line. Lindell steps in front of Ottinger. Now Haskin in for Gurianov. Through the legs of Pettersson to the slot, puck loose, side of the cage, and Gurianov was behind the end line. Couldn't settle, didn't have the angle. Jeff Carter the other way. 95-foot tester, no problem for Ottinger. Here's Suter. Across the Dallas line, gains center. Tosses it in, awaiting Matheson. And Ruidel for Zach Aston-Reese. He'll get to the red line and chip it in from there. Tyler Seguin, pass for Suter. As a man up ahead, it was Hintz. Took a little while longer to get there, and the window closed.
Seeing some guys with their skating stride put the fear of God into the Penguins at times. You know, you think of Hintz back in the second period, Gurionov here early in the third. That's a big, big part of the Stars' attack.
Dumoulin to Laté. Up to Rodriguez. Crosby's across the line, trying to slice through a one-handed shot. Nottinger got just enough.
What a great shimmy by Crosby to generate some space.
Peterson, nice change of direction, snapped the shot. Jari equal to that one. Robertson back to Pavelski to the right. He was looking for Peterson and just poked away in time. Good chances at both ends, opening 2.5 minutes of this third period. Couple of circles inside the Dallas zone for Klingberg as personnel changes complete. Sekera off of Kiviranta. Now Marino the chip, gloved down by Sekera. He was out of the lineup last three into the pause, and then on Thursday night back in. Here's Friedman across, Heinen put it off the bar. He had the entire net to shoot at. Hit the near post that time on the second effort, wider angle, caught the outside of the net. Carter tapping in. Sekera cancels. Carter could not walk around Ben. Stars dodge another close call for Pittsburgh, and it stays a one-goal game.
Yeah, I mean, they've been within an eyelash of that third goal all game long, it feels like, and got to live right a little bit when I come back in hockey games.
Dallas was able to make the most of opportunities like that on Thursday. Heavy hit. Roope Hintz cut Pettersson behind the net. And icing against Pittsburgh.
Well, they've been dashing up and down the ice to begin the third period. Crosby with that little sway, and he scored goals on that one-hand backhand like or stab like that. Nice delay at the other end by Peterson to generate a tester for Jari, and then the pipe. Man, the inside of the pipe and through too as Heinen crept down the weak side.
Race for the puck. Suter got there just in front of Simone.
Think of that chance for Heinen, the one with Rodriguez back in the second.
Pavelski tracks it to the corner. Slow moving for Hintz, who's intercepted by Boyle, then Pettersson. Turned over, and the Stars have it. Suter steps down the wing to Robertson. Off the stick, dances the dasher to the near side. Top line out there for Dallas. Pavelski's pass just out of the reach of Robertson. An assist on the Stars' lone goal, has points in 10 straight games now in this building. He'll feed it up high for Suter. Shot! The traffic in front. Stars get it right back. Hintz. Bouncing puck. Robertson taken away. Not cleared. Heiskanen shot. And that off traffic at the top of the crease. Stars have pressure. Robertson. Sharp angle save. Rebound. Another save. From one post to the other. Jari denies Pavelski. And now Peppers flare once again following the whistle.
Bjorkvist gave the puck right back to the Stars after they had gained control. There's been a lot of kind of stand and straight-legged defending from the Penguins since the first period. And it's Jari to the rescue again. Lekkinen split laterally to get the rebound offering. Bit of a corpulent one off the body, and Pavelski no room to go, and a dog pile in the aftermath of it. Yeah, the top line, these guys were silent in the first period. They never generated a shot on goal. The Penguins were having their way, and everybody's got, you know, a little more of an edge, some sandpaper to their game since that shift from Radulov in the second, and they've looked like the better team a lot.
Ben line out there. Stars win the draw, and Heiskanen tried a one-timer, mostly missed. Puck was just a little in front of where he wanted it to be. Grabbed by Bluger. He's got Kapanen as he races in. Kapanen caught from behind by Gurionov. No penalty on the play. Terrific defensive play. Logged up in the trapezoid, then Haskin gets it around. Race to the vacant corner. Sagan. And back to the near side. On the far boards, Rodriguez ducked past a check attempt from Ben. Gurionov has time to settle. And played it back, didn't realize it was Rodriguez. Given away, Gensel in the slot. And that cleaned up by Hockenpah with the block. Now it's Crosby cutting, saved by Odger. A penalty coming up. Here's a chance, another save by Odger on Matheson.
Well, the good and the bad from Denis Gurionov. Great hustle initially to get back. It's tracking, and he can pick him up and put him down. Kapanen can fly. Just great effort by Gurionov defensively, but they win a puck back again. He's just assuming that the Penguins have left the zone. He can drop it back to a D-man. The D were changing, and the chance after that, Crosby in tight, and then another from distance absorbed by Jake Oettinger. He might have to come up with a couple more of these elite stops to keep the Penguins from that third goal, which has been elusive today.
Slashing the goal against Gurionov.
There's a lot going on. That was high event Denis Gurionov on that shift.
You're 100% right, though. It's one of those plays you see so many times throughout a game from both teams. You just don't expect it's going to go right to the guys in the opposing colors. Rodriguez was as surprised as anyone.
It's not offside when you send it back in there.
If that comes from a teammate, that's not even close. Here's Letang. And that pass does bring it back on the other side of the line. So we haven't seen much from this Pittsburgh power play, but they got another 25 left on this opportunity. Third of the game. Letang. Rodriguez stays with it high slot. And a backhand feed, Letang. He's pressured up high, Glendening. Over to Rodriguez. Sent it through. Crosby takes it off the boards. 5-on-4 for Pittsburgh. They got the one-goal lead. Rodriguez delays, and he was looking far side and just shot it a little too far.
That was good work by Oettinger to kind of dance and prance with him. Gave him nothing.
Rodriguez again. And cleared by the Stars.
Rodriguez and Raffel in behind the plate at one another. You notice number 9 for them, don't you?
Do you ever look at the score sheet, the 15 goals this season, and looks every bit the part in this game. Stars steal, shorthanded Raffel, trying to break in, delays, and he was looking for hits. That magical shorthanded connection, already struck twice this season, they couldn't there. Simone to the point, Matheson. Down to just 10 seconds left in the Gurionov slash. Stars clear, and they're going to get through it.
You have to think the Penguins wish they could trot Evgeny Malkin out there for these power play opportunities. He's always been one of the major weapons for them. Not dressed here again today, and their power play's done them no favors.
Crowd saluting the 3-for-3 effort so far from the Stars penalty kill. Keeping them in the game, keeping them within a goal for the time being. Just under a dozen minutes left in the third period. Puck gets past Dumoulin, racing after it. Ben, he tried to lunge forward. Winds up in the benches, out of play. Good start here in this third period. Still a one-goal game advantage, Pens.
He has been a weapon. He's been dangerous. Anticipates, hustles. Real good defensive play by Marino to kind of hang with Hintz. Take his stick, sifts through him. They don't get the tying goal shorthanded. Boy, they just consume so much video information now in game, between periods, prior to games, post games. They'll get on the plane after this one and head to St. Louis and they'll watch their shifts on a tablet, on the flight, unless they're playing cards, and then move on to tomorrow against St. Louis. But they have designs on getting at least something out of this game this afternoon. And if they can come back and win it, it would be the first time this season they've won a game where they trailed after the opening 20 minutes of play. And they were down big, 2-0, and could have been bigger.
Before all the screens, what was a conversation like that on the bench here?
You just look around and you're like, hey, is that your dad over there?
Letang for Gensel. Rodriguez up ahead. He will drive it in. Lindell reversing for Hockenpah. Lost his twig. Stepping out of the corner, Rodriguez. Good positioning by Fox to the intercept. Possession back to Dallas. Glendening. Had a whole lot of Sidney Crosby up the ice. Got it in deep nonetheless. Chip to the star zone. Hockenpah goes as Gensel changes.
Boy, they're very strict with their shift length, the Penguins, too. I mean, nobody really extends a shift. It is 40 seconds and off, no matter what your name is.
This is the third game in 3.5 days for them. Quick shot, Hanson, and the rebound put just wide. Similar situation with the Stars will be dealing with tomorrow in St. Louis as Jari hangs up.
Yeah, I think you're seeing some of that as it's moved along, too. They've looked like they've been down a pint in the energy department in some regards, and I'm sure their MO heading in to the game was, hey, look, let's throw everything at them early, get ahead, and see if we can hang on. And the Stars are finding their legs a little bit. Another good rush chance for Roope Hintz there. And they're going to face the same animal tomorrow in St. Louis.
Matheson clears. Suter drops at his feet. Over to Haskin. Ahead for Robertson. He gets pickpocketed. Kapanen the other way. 3-on-2 Pittsburgh. Kapanen pass for Heinen. Right back to Kapanen. Down to the circle, Heinen. Top of the zone now, Matheson. Area pass to the corner. First there, Haskinen. And the Stars exit. Suter. Across the Pittsburgh line, Pavelski. Robertson. Back for Pavelski. Cross, Haskinen off the boards. At the blue line, Suter. Left side, Robertson. Nothing there as Bluger closed off the lane. Robertson is so good, so patient with the puck, just turns away from traffic and keeps possession. Pavelski, Suter in front, Peterson! And Jari with the save, and a full four-man box out of the Stars as Jari hung on. Half a period left in Dallas, it's the Penguins leading 2-1.
It is time now for our Chevy Under the Hood, and this one is featuring a star-studded and highly productive 2017 draft class. I talked to Jason Robertson on what it means to be a part of such a successful group. He says, I think it's something special, saying that you can be a part of a draft that gave your team players that can help the franchise, especially that each position was drafted, which doesn't happen very often. Took a lot of pride in that, and they still keep chipping away, guys.
That's one that very quickly you thought could be franchise altering, and seems to get better by the year. Stars in search of that equalizer. They have trailed for most of this game. Gave up the first two goals back in the first. Puck up and out of play just over the benches. Braden Holtby gave that one a little jumping attempt.
Steve Sumner in behind him. Sudsy, the Stars' longtime equipment man, his wife April celebrating a birthday in the building today. Just a minute ago, Holtby made a save with that glove hand. Stay active, lost his bucket. A lot of hair flowing around down there.
Holtby's getting an ovation. They're showing the same thing on the big board up here. Expect to see him tomorrow in St. Louis. Lindbergh lost the puck. Gensel. He gets canceled out by Foxa. Chip Glendening. Raffle chasing after. Bumps off Letang. Races for contact in the trapezoid. Gensel from one blue line to the other.
It's been a good matchup this afternoon. That line for the Stars against Crosby's line. It was a purposeful shift from Crosby and company. They got into the zone trying to pressure the puck, but nothing came from it.
Driven in by Sagan. Hurry on up. Puck got away from Ben. And Kapanen can fly. He'll take it wide down the right side. A shot saved by Andre. Pettersson. And that one caromed up high, stayed in play. Heinen. And then Ben over skating. And Suter all the way down. Icing against the Stars.
Our Ford leaderboard today focuses on that home point scoring streak of Jason Robertson. As he's tucked another one. Apparently the Colorado Avalanche have been fairly good at home lately. It's Robertson with 10 straight games. Nazem Kadri for the Avs with 10 straight. Gabriel Landeskog of the Avs with 10 straight. Nathan MacKinnon with 9. Mikko Rantanen with 9.
Stars only make the one trip to Denver this year. It was supposed to be just after Christmas before New Year's. One of the 6 days postponed. Let's see if maybe Colorado slowed down by the time they get there. Ruidel puts it in. Ottinger gives a glance. Niskanen. Fight for the puck, and then Pettersson couldn't get it out. Matheson slow moving as he fanned. And then Gurianov starts it the other way. Stick actually broke, and then it looked like the Penguins had too many men. Someone had to jump back on. I think it was Matheson. He jumped and landed in the bench. That went uncalled. Play goes on. Niskanen shovels. Stopped by Ruidel. And angles it across. Suter. Jacob Pettersson. Edge of the trapezoid. Kiviranta. Down to a knee. Gets back up. Niskanen to Suter. Radulov on the backhand. Blocked by bodies on the wall. Kiviranta, Suter, shot, and he just missed the net. He came free with space. Holtby bombs it down for Suter. Clock ticks under 7 to play in regulation. Stars trailing by a goal. Crosby intercepts. Couldn't get it through to Rodriguez. The Stars are in. Pavelski gets forced off by Marino. Miguel in front of Rodriguez. Hakanpaa again off the stick of Crosby, sent it up and out of play.
Our Discover Card matchup here this afternoon. The two netminders. Jari came in a very stingy guy for the Penguins, and he's been tough to beat here today. Ottinger, you know, I think the inactivity again affected him in the early going. I like this about Jake Ottinger. He's had some of those, you know, starts to games where it's like, well, this could go really wrong, but he's got a mental toughness in him and battles through. He's looked rock solid. Obviously, he's stopped everything since the early opening period. So a good matchup between these two young netminders.
Get the feeling like at either side, still could be one huge save that has a big say in how this turns out. Here is Fox on the left wing, Glendening. One's come away with it, Rodriguez. Chips. Ottinger came out to play it between the hash marks. And the Stars turn it over, Rodriguez. Looking for help, flips it in front, bouncing puck, and Carter never had room to shoot.
There was a good hustle by Radek Fox, a stride for stride with him to break it up.
Raffle to Lindell. On the backhand, Glendening for Ben. He'll slice him with speed, but knocked off. Heinen went down in contact with Ben.
Like Jamie was going semi-beast mode there. He's just like, get out of my way. I'll go through you or around you.
Gurianov to Sagan. Back to Gurianov. Ben there as well. Letang broke it up. The giveaway. Gurianov. Sharp angle and sealed off by Jari. He was hugging the post, made the stop.
And whoopsie-daisy at both ends with the puck.
Sekera. Klingberg. Pressured by Aston Reese. Those two have had quite a battle in the game. Aston Reese has just been all over Klingberg. Klingberg through neutral. Across the line. To the right side. Then a pass broken up by Boyle. Held Robertson shot. Save, rebound.
Well, they're able to win the battle on the boards initially. You know, take the line. John Klingberg's like a ghost on those zone entries. And then, you know, it's simple stuff, right? Just throw it to the net. Get it to the net front. Put it in the fondue pot. And those quick hands, the great awareness of Joe Pavelski. There's no secret where you score most of your goals in this league. And after a slow start to the afternoon, the Pavelski, Robertson, Hintz trios had a pretty good game as it's moved along, and a mammoth goal to tie it.
13th of the year for Pavelski. Puck out of play. He moves in to sole possession of the team lead in goal scoring. That's a huge one. And we are even 2-2 with under 5 to play.
Took it to the Stars in the first period. Dumoulin, the defenseman, opened the score 6 minutes in. A half a minute after that, Kapanen in front of the net, little depth deflection, they're up 2-0, and they really owned the first period. But the Stars started to let the Cougar loose in the second period. Tested Jari repeatedly, played better and better, had their legs under them, got feisty around the net front, came close to getting on the board, finally did on a broken play, Denis Gurionov. The only goal of the middle frame. Early in the third, both sides had opportunities to change the score. Off the pipe, scrambles around the net. Rodriguez has been all over it, but off the scoreboard here today. And finally, Joe Pavelski, like a hockey hyena around the front of the net, knots it at 2.
Latang grabs. Ahead to Rodriguez. Crosby will chip it in from center. Ottinger stays put. Boxer rims it around, but it goes to Dumoulin. Rodriguez. It's written off by Lindell. Stars come away with it. Michael Roffel. Over to Fox up. He'll chip in from the center line. Chase after it. Rest of his line mates change it. Stretch pass. The toe of Heinen. Think about the post that he had and all of those close calls. Stars right there with under 4 to play now. Looking for their first lead of the game, and they're in. It's Hintz with Robertson. Hintz to Robertson out of midair. Got a shot away. Then Jari with the save. Rebound score. Hintz. Dallas in front.
I'm not sure what Jeff Carter was doing there. He's been culpable on a couple of Stars goals, but he pushed up in neutral ice. Great hand-eye work by Jason Robertson initially at the net front to even control the puck. It goes aerial once, twice above the ice. Haskinen's down deep as a defenseman, and it plops past Tristan Jari, who was in full scramble mode. Never got control. Quick hands from Hintz, pulls it in front, tucks it home. The Stars have their first lead of the afternoon.
For 56 minutes, the Stars were no better than even on the board, but they've got a lead at the most important time. And now 3.5 away from the finish line, they go for the win in regulation, trying to snap Pittsburgh's NHL-high 10-game winning streak. No time to waste as he circles out of the Penguin zone. Two goals, a minute 15 apart from the Stars. Pavelski followed by Hintz. Turn a deficit into a lead. Sidney Crosby off a skate over the glass, out of play. Exactly 3 minutes shows on the clock.
Well, Crosby's been kept off the goal sheet again in Dallas with 3 minutes to go in regulation. You would think this would be a frenetic final 3 minutes from a Penguins perspective, trying to keep their winning streak alive. What a rally, though, for the Stars to dig out of an 0-2 hole.
Dumoulin slow-moving. Letang, a shot. Traffic in front of Ottinger. Right back to Letang. Dumoulin, one-timer, blocked by Roppel. Didn't know where it was. So it's right back to Dumoulin. Lindell applying the pressure. Right side, Gensel. Roppel pursued by Gensel. Good play to just bounce it out to center. Stars can get a partial change-in. 2.5 to go now in regulation. Jari staying put for the time being while it's rimmed around. Comes all the way out. Back to the Penguins' end. It's Marino. Outlet feed. Aston Reese for Bluger. Got past him. Suter. Then Bluger takes it away. Feeds it in front. Hintz was there. Intercepts. Roope Hintz. Chips it in from the center line. Rolls to the side of the cage, and then Jari secures it with 1:54 remaining.
I think Marino shot it on his own goaltender there, and Jari had to be alert. And a faceoff will keep him in net here. If they get control up the ice, he's headed to the bench. Crosby back on the ice. They just look like they haven't been able to keep up with the Stars' tenacity as the game's moved along here today. And they've been very spread out, nowhere near as swift as a group or individually as they were in the first period. The Stars have caught them and bettered them.
Ben against Crosby. Crosby wins the faceoff. Now Jari under pressure is, and the Stars there. Sagan takes it away. Plays it off the glove of Jari. Gurianov feeds it to Hakanpää. The Stars are set up in the attack zone. They've got to be aware that they're holding Jari. They're holding the Penguins. Down to 90 seconds left. Pittsburgh in an awkward change. Turns into a giveaway. They thought Jari was going to come. He was never able to. He hangs on. Down to just 1:23 left.
Page, our car shield protection play of the game. We'll call it plays of the game. It's Ottinger against E-Rod, as they call him. Evan Rodriguez, who's had his opportunities in the game. He's had some pucks past Ottinger, but not in the frame of the net in the 6x4. As one of the hottest scorers in the league, mano a mano with young Ottinger, who's unbeatable, it feels, at the end of things on home ice. We'll see where this one ends up here. Timeout has been taken. Not a surprise to try to get their Ducks in a row, or Penguins, and see whether they can get this thing to level here this afternoon. But this is a heck of a rally for the Stars. And they needed Ottinger to just slam the door after they went down 2-0. Yeah, the win percentage here at home in his career, he's fifth best. Some pretty talented netminders on that list. And he is a minute 23 away from notching another one.
Crosby and the Penguins trying for one last plot twist. Coming into play here this afternoon, the Penguins are 18-0-1 this season when leading at second intermission. Don't come back against this team. The Stars, though, have. Face-off win. Penguins have it. Jari will look to get to the bench. As the puck moves through center, Ottinger stops it casually with the skate off the carom. Empty net now for Pittsburgh. Chip out by Dallas. Out of the reach of Fox. Lindell has it from the center circle, and it's blocked by Rodriguez.
1 minute,
the final minute now
period.
Of regulation. Stars hanging on to a 3-2 lead. Letang shoots it in. Hakanpää touches. They'll rule it was batted down with a high stick by the Stars, and that brings a whistle. Fans, you can lace up your skates and hit the ice for a public skating session. Grab your friends and family and head to your local Children's Health Star Center. Sessions are open to skaters of all levels and ages. can view the full schedule at DallasStars.com/public skating. Discussion before this face-off. Sidney Crosby and the officials. It was whistled down, played with a high stick, and touched by Hockenpah. They're going to move it over to the blocker side circle of Ottinger, the one closest to where Hockenpah was when he touched it. Glendening against Crosby.
Man, Crosby's taking a lot of face-offs today.
And he wins this one. Shot Carter. Ottinger awaits it with the left hand.
See, like, you look at that save here now at the end of the game. You look at the beginning of the game when he got beat on a wrist shot. Better depth in his net, beat on it. Little sass to the glove grab. He's been terrific again.
And Denning and Crosby do it again. 47.3 remains. Penguins win the draw. They set up in the 6-on-5. Crosby left dot. On the backhand to Letang. He's got Rodriguez. Shot! Traffic in front never got through. Plank to the near side boards. Gensel shot. That one stayed out. Just outside the crease. Pressure. Pops free to Letang with under half a minute to go. It's Letang to the left wing side, capping it. He'll flip to Letang. Glendening measures. Rodriguez to Crosby. Up high now, Letang. Sharp angle, one-timer. Save, Ottinger. Rebound. Clear. 10 seconds left. Penguins have to touch up. Last hope for them. It's Rodriguez. Funnels low. Banks over to Kapanen. 2 seconds left. A delay. A fumble. And a comeback win for the Stars.
And there are a lot of guys that are going to deserve a lot of credit at the end of this one here today. You know, that checking unit against their top guys were marvelous. The penalty killing completely asphyxiated the Penguin power play throughout the game. And then the guys you expect to score for you when you get opportunities did just that in the rally. But to dig out of an 0-2 hole here and win a game against a team that is rocking along is mighty impressive.
The longest winning streak in the NHL snapped at 10 games, courtesy of a Stars comeback win. All three goals in the second half of the game, the two that changed it, Pavelski and Hintz, just over a minute apart late. What a win for the Stars as they hit the road. For Daryl Ray, Michelle McMahon, our terrific crew, I'm Josh Bogorod. 3-2, Stars win it. Post-game show is next.